Good evening and a very warm welcome to St. Dominic's. This event has taken 2 years of cancellations to make good. So we're very, very happy to see you. There's a blended audience, a blend of American Guild of Organists and congregations from St. Mary the Virgin over the hill and St. Dominic's. Everybody is extremely welcome in our building. At the break, that's the halfway point back there, there's a box of programs. We suggest you do not sit in that front row of the break by the space because the choirs will appear there later on and might use their elbows to make room. So there are plenty of other seats. If you're a singer and if you can read music and enjoy it, there are copies of the final anthem on the communion rail and we are going to invite you to sing that with us. Okay, so you have to come and be brave and come and collect some copies of I Was Glad. They're just here on the communion rail. And we'll let you do that now so we don't interrupt again later on. There's a brave person. Thank you. Organists, where are you? Know this piece. Good. So we'll do that. And whilst you're collecting those copies, we'll start with our first piece, a very, very quiet, meditative beginning of Elgar's Nimrod. You've seen that tonight's program is called Pairings, for we have pairs of compositions, mostly an organ composition followed by a choral composition by the same composer. Like wine pairings, I suppose. That last piece, The Spirit of the Lord, is perhaps not as difficult as it is to sing as you might think. And if you have a church choir, don't hesitate to get a set of copies and to sing it. But you will need an expert organist. And there are reduced versions for easy organ playing. What Chris Keady has just done is play for an even more complicated arrangement. And so I really want to thank him and congratulate him for managing that so well on little rehearsal and supporting us. He certainly had the hard part in all of this. So thank you, Chris, very much. Eric Choate is our next organist, and he'll also conduct the next piece, both in this F-sharp tonality by Messiaen, which he saw as a tonality of goodness and kindness. He called it the superhuman love tonality because he had that ability to hear and see colors in music. You'll find then these two pieces mirror each other quite well, both near the beginning of his life, same tonality. On page 5 of your programs, you have the hymn, When I Survey the Wondrous Cross, and we'll invite you to sing, of course, that with us, verses 1, 2, and 3, H, meaning in harmony, and verse 4, you, meaning in unison, everybody singing the melody. You have to work out, as an organist, whether you stand when the hymn is announced, whether you stand when the organist plays the first two or three notes, whether you leave it until the end of the play over in case you're the first person to stand, or maybe you stand once you've finished consuming that mint that you have in the back of your mouth. It's a conundrum. Congregations here stand when it's time to sing. In some churches, they stand on the first note. We invite you to stand at your ease and comfort during the organ introduction and sing lustily and heartily, please. This great tune and these fabulous words, they deserve our commitment. If you're an organist, choir director, I'm sure you know the next piece. I sat down under his shadow, a very beautiful miniature. But how many of you know, though I speak with the tongues of men? Could you, if you know this piece, could you put your paw in the air? I'm not seeing. Isn't that interesting? It's a wonderful piece of music that very, very well describes the Corinthians text. And instead of using the word love, it uses the old-fashioned word charity, which seems to say a lot more than love. I'd like to make two dedications at this point of the program to Dr. Francis Jackson, who died recently, aged 103, who wrote the biography of Edward Bairstow and was intimately familiar with his music because they both shared the organ loft at different times at York Minster. Secondly, to Tom Vinson, who's a major supporter of our music program over many years, who could do with some prayers for healing at the moment. When we get to the end of the program and we sing I Was Glad, I hope the organist amongst us will remember Simon Preston, sometime organist of Westminster Abbey, fabulous recitalist, was at Grace Cathedral a few years ago, terribly funny, committed man, terribly skilled, and he played I Was Glad many, many times at the Abbey for special occasions. He died quite young recently, last week, and so we should dedicate, in his memory, the performance of I Was Glad.
Oh.
it's almost your turn to sing again in our next hymn, Abide With Me. There's a note in the program about somebody who I think foolishly denigrated this wonderful set of words and sweeping Edwardian tune. It also means a great deal to us when we come to the end of our earthly lives to sing and to meditate on these words. It's a form of portable theology we take with us when we're walking down the street and perhaps thinking about the harder things in life. We hope you've come tonight mostly to hear wonderful music, and you'll notice that we've not revealed which organist is playing which piece. Because I hope you want to hear the music more than a certain organist or maybe a certain instrument. But we will reveal that the most complicated music was played perhaps by the organist of St. Mary the Virgin or Grace Cathedral or St. Dominic's. And if you are the rector of St. Mary the Virgin, you have a very fine organist and choir director. And if you are the Dean of Grace Cathedral, you're indeed fortunate to have a wonderful organist there too. If you're a member of a congregation, hold on to your organists. They are valuable items. They are the people who support your parishes and evangelize through music. Hold on to them dearly. So, please sing heartily, Abide With Me.
Thank you.
If you're singing with us, first choir this side, yes. Second choir that side, that means I would stop you to change voice parts. If you enjoy singing, you may have noticed that quite a lot of this music comes from English or English, because we're just about to celebrate Queen's birthday, she's 96, and she has 70 years on the throne. And as a loyal Englishman and American, I'm thrilled to live through these days, and hope to be here very soon. To help celebrate that, I invite you all, if you'd like, to sing with us.